Welcome to the St. Peter's Engineering College. Myself, V. Gajendra, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering. So I'm going to be teaching the subject surveying and geomatics. In this today's session, I'm going to be discussing about Unit 2, leveling. In previous session, so I discussed about that the what is meant by, what are the objects of leveling and uses of leveling and important definitions that we are going to be using in the leveling surveying. Anyway, now in continuation with that, after understanding that the what are the objects of the leveling, uses of the leveling. So then my next is going to be called instrument used for leveling. Instruments used for leveling. Instrument used for leveling. Instruments used for leveling work is, one is level instrument, level. Another one is going to be called as level staff. Level instrument and the leveling staff. So leveling instruments are there, the different types of the levels are available. So main objective of the leveling is that, so we are going to be finding out the elevation or the vertical measurement by using the leveling instrument with the help of leveling staff. So that is the objective we are going to be using with the leveling survey, is the vertical measurement, or you can say that the elevation or the height we are going to be using with the leveling instrument with the help of leveling staff. Number one, dumpy level. Number two, Y level. Number three, tilting level. Number four, automatic level. So these are the types of levels. Leveling instrument is the first instrument is going to be called a level. Level will be the different types of the levels. Level instruments are available: dumpy level, Y level, tilting level, and automatic level. So, what are the features of dumpy level, and what are the uses of the dumpy level? What are the uses of Y level? What is the use of tilting level? And what is the use of automatic level? Now the first type is going to be called as a dumpy level. So the dumpy level, this is going to be using for the most of the leveling work, almost all the in the field operations for to go for the vertical measurements. Dumpy level is going to be called as commonly used instruments nowadays. But dumpy level will be having that, if you see that leveling head, stripe iron, leveling head. So this is going to be called as a telescope. This is going to be called as eyepiece. And this is going to be called as object glass or object end. Object end and eyepiece end. So from here, we are going to be looking through that one. Eyepiece is going to be called as the inlet, or we are going to be called as the, so through that the eyes, we are going to be looking through that the object, and object end we are able to see that. So this is going to be called imaginary line passing through that one. So that we can able to see that the objects, the eyepiece will be having that the crosshairs is going to be giving that vertical measurement, and object end, we are going to be giving that viewing of the object. So one end is going to be called as, that is the facing end is going to be called as eyepiece end, and far end we are able to have the object end with the telescope. This is called the at dumpy level how it is going to be manufactured and how it is going to be prepared. And that is going to be keep it on the tripod. This is going to be called as a stand on the tripod. We are going to keep it out. So what is the use of the dumpy level here? The major part is going to be called a telescope. Telescope is going to be rigidly fixed to the leveling head. Rigidly fixed to the leveling head. And through the IPCM, we can able to see the crosshairs, and through that the object end, we are able to finding out the vertical distances. Wherever it is going to be intersecting of the crosshairs in the eyepiece with the object, we are able to finding out the vertical distances. Here, completely, your telescope is going to be rigidly fixed to the leveling head. Then we cannot able to take it out. And once the instrument is going to be leveled, then the instrument is going to be ready to take out the vertical distances with the help of eyepiece and of the object end. And we are going to be finding out the intersection of the crosshairs with the object. We are going to be taking out the readings through that with the help of the leveling staff. This is the feature or we are going to be using of the dumpy level. Very simple, simple and handy instrument. We are going to be finding out the vertical distances or the vertical measurements by using the dumpy level. Here the main important is that your telescope is going to be rigidly fixed. We cannot able to take it out. And with that, so we are able to finding out that the vertical distances are the vertical height. Next is the Y level. So here the telescope is so fixed on the Y supports. Telescope is going to be fixed on the Y supports. So telescope is going to be placed under the Y support. That's why we are going to call it Y level. So here there are the two curved clips. Y supports will be having that the two curved clips. So two curved clips means your telescope So this is the Y support and this is the Y support. In the Y supports, it is going to be placed. So like this Y curved clips, the two curved clips will be there. In that, the telescope is going to be placed. And here we can able to take it out. The telescope is going to be take it out. It's not going to be rigidly fixed. In previous dumpy level, we can have the dumpy level telescope is going to be rigidly fixed. We are not going to be replaced or we are not going to be take it out. So only unless otherwise we have to go for the permanent adjustments only. So we are going to be doing that the permanent adjustments for the telescope of the dumpy level. Here the telescope can able to say change the eyepiece. So this is the we are able to call it as eyepiece end, and this is going to be called as object end. Object end will be there. So this object end we can able to place over here, and eyepiece we are able to place it. So the changing of eyepiece to the object end to the eyepiece is going to be possible. Reversing of the telescope is going to be taking place in case of the Y level. And also if you want to rotate the longitudinal axis, it also is going to be possible in the case of the Y level. But in the case of the dumpy level, it is not going to be rotated. It is going to be rigidly fixed and it is not going to be mobile one. But in Y level, so that is going to be the advantage while you are able to see that. So we can able to take it out, and we are going to be changing eyepiece end to the object end and object end into the eyepiece. And also we can able to raise the height of the telescope with respect to the two curved clips. Two curved clips is going to be lifted up, and we can able to take it out the telescope, and we can able to change end to end. So object end is going to be one other end, and the eyepiece end is going to be changes instead of the initial positions. So that is the advantage while you are going to be using the Y level, and the rotation of the telescope is also going to be possible. But in the dumpy level, rotation of the telescope is not possible. It is going to be rigidly fixed. And this is about the Y level. Then the next one is going to be called as a tilting level. So here the advantage is the telescope can able to tilt it by using that the tilting screw. So the telescope is going to be tilted by the tilting screw. Previous case in the Y level, it is going to be rotated with the longitudinal axis. Is possible by using the curved clips, but here by using the tilting screw, the telescope can able to tilt. So that is going to be inclined. So in the dumpy level, it is rigidly fixed. Y level is not going to be fixed. We can able to rotate it. In telescope level, it is going to be fixed, but it is going to be tilted. Tilting of the telescope is going to be possible. Means. So this is the standard position of the telescope, and now it is going to be tilted. So this the tilting is going to be possible. This is the normal position. Tilting is going to be possible in this direction. With respect to the horizontal, so this is the tilting position. So the telescope can able to tilt this direction by using that the tilting screw. By using tilting screw, and each and every time here we had to be check that leveling of the instrument. That is the line of collimation. So before going to be taking the reading, so we had to be corrected the line of collimation, or we are going to call as line of sight. Already we defined. So this is going to be called as the imaginary line passing through the intersection of the crosshairs in the diaphragm of the eyepiece, the intersection of the crosshairs to the object end of the object glass. So continuation, its continuation is going to be called as line of collimation or line of sight. If line of sight is going to be perfect, means it is going to be leveled through the foot screws of a leveling instrument. So then your line of sight is going to be perfect. If the line of sight, and that's why in the tilting level, we are going to be, while before we are going to be taking the measurement, we had to be check it, line of sight or the line of collimation is perfect or not. We had to, once again, we are going to be doing the line of collimation each and every setup of the reading. But in the case of dumpy level, only once line of collimation you are going to be adjusted with the help of the foot screws. So then it is not going to be disturbed in the case of the Y level or in the case of the dumpy level. But tilting level, each and every time we had to be checked and we had to be modify that the line of collimation before we are going to be taking the reading. So then we had to be corrected the line of collimation with the help of the foot screws, because it is going to be tilted by using the tilting screw. So tilting is always is going to be disturbing your leveling up of the instrument, level of the instrument. Due to that reason, so we are going to be corrected each and every reading. And then we have to be, progress of the work is going to be carried out. This is about the tilting level. Then next one is going to be called as automatic level. Automatic level. Or we are going to be called as auto level. Auto level. Similar to that the dumpy level, similar to the dumpy level, but here automatic leveling operation. Automatic leveling by laser beam. Automatic leveling by the laser beam is going to be possible. So leveling has to be done automatically. Leveling and centering can done by automatically by using the laser beam and as well as with the foot screws. So in the dumpy level or the Y level or the tilting level, each and every time manually we have to be do that the leveling with the help of the foot screws. That is going to be there in the leveling head that's going to be provided. So here in the automatic level, the term itself is going to be giving the meaning auto level, automatic level or the auto level. So with the sophisticated arrangement of laser beam, centering has to be completed. So then the bubble is going to be make it to the center. The bubble is going to make it to the center in such a way that your instrument is going to be perfectly leveled. So the percentage of error is going to be very, very less. This is a 99% accuracy we are able to get it from the centering and leveling with the help of the sophisticated arrangement. But in the case of dumpy level, or you take the Y level or the tilting level, so the tendency of the error, the tolerance level is plus or minus 2. Plus or minus will be there. Plus or minus is not that much, 99%. It is going to be called a 90% to 95% accuracy only. We are going to be achieving by the dumpy level, Y level, or the tilting level. That's why automatic level or auto level is going to be called advanced. Advanced from the whatever the, so the difficulties arises by using at the dumpy level, it is going to be eliminated by using that the auto level. So auto level or the automatic level. So it is going to be very fast, and accuracy is going to be 99% of accuracy. We are able to get the readings, and is going to be reducing the time for centering and leveling operations while you are going to be taking in the place of dumpy level. So a lot of time is going to be consumed for centering and leveling up of the instrument. So then we have to go for the taking of the readings. So that is the advantage while you are going to be using the automatic level or the auto level. Then in the leveling survey, we are going to be doing that instruments used for leveling survey. So one is the instrument we use, it is going to be called as level, and second one is a staff. So level already we discussed, it is going to be called a dumpy level, Y level, tilting level, and automatic level. Then it is going to be coming to the staff. So we are going to be called as, the staff is going to have two classifications are there. One is self-ready staff. Self-reading one type of staff. Another one is going to be called as target staff. So self-reading, and the second type of the staff is going to be, so these are the two types of the staffs are available. One is self-reading, another one is going to be target. What is meant by the self-reading? Self-reading will be having, actually the staff is going to be made with the, the staff will be having 4 meters maximum length available. Length is 4 meters is going to be available. It's going to be split into, split into 2 meter plus 2 meter. So earlier it is going to be available with that the wood. Now it is going to be called as steel. Steel is also the wooden staff, or the steel staff, or also is going to be steel or metal staff is going to be available. So the 2 meters and 2 meters is going to be called as the bottom most, and then it is going to be, so like this will be there. So here the catch will be there too. It is going to be inserting into that one, inserting into, so the bottom most one. So this will be 2 meters length, and this is another 2 meters length. 2 meters, 2 meters, the maximum length available is 4 meters. So in the one is, we are going to be called as self-reading. The self-reading staff, in this here, so readings are going to be graduated. Readings is going to be graduated. Here the least count is 5 mm. So least count is 5 mm. Least count is 5 mm. For the staff reading, self-reading is the least count. Means each graduation will be having 5 mm, 5 mm. Like that, it is going to be called as 1 meter, 2 meters, and it is going to be having white and the red. Red is going to be giving the markings. White and black and red is going to be giving the markings, such that we can able to visible from the far longer distances also. So that's why it will be marked with that the black and red combination. Black and red combination. Black is the graduations. Red is going to be giving as the numbers, so we can able to read through the telescope. If the telescope is going to be provided, so it can go for up to the distance, but how much visible distance will be there, that that is depending upon that the focal length of the telescope. That will be depending upon the focal length of the wave. So in the here, what is going to happen? Self reading. So the double man is going to be looking through the telescope, and he can able to read that the staff, and the staff man is going to be holding that the staff, and the level man is going to be taking the reading through that the telescope. So that's why it is going to be called a self reading, reading through that the telescope, reading through the telescope. That we are going to call self reading. The length of the staff is going to be available 4 meters. The 4 meters is not the single length. It is going to be split into 2 meters. Split into 2 meters and 2 meters. Lower case will be having 2 meters length. 2 meters length. This is 2 meters, and upper case is going to be called 2 meters. That is the spring catch will be there. We can able to insert into that the lower case. And whenever if you the reading is going to be more than 2 meters, we can able to extend it. If the staff is not going to be visible through that the telescope, then we are going to extend it the upper more upper part, and it will go up to 2 meters. Total length 4 meters, but whenever it is necessary only, we are going to be lifting up the upper portion. Otherwise, bottom portion, we will be giving as a 2 meters with the least count of 5 mm, or each division will be 5 mm, marking with 1 meter, 2 meters, 3 meters, and 4 meters. So like that, we are going to be using in the self-reading staff. So next one is going to be called as targeted staff. Next is going to be called as target staff. Means you can able to see that this is the stuff, either the metal or the so here what is going to happen, the target will be there. So this is the target. So it is going to be the target will be moving. So the in the previous case, in the self-reading one, this is the target staff. In self-reading one, in the self-reading one, what is going to happen? Level man looking through the telescope, and he can able to read that the staff, and he can able to note it down the reading. But here, so what is going to happen? The target is going to be taken care by the level staff man. Staff man, so he is going to be moving. This is going to be called as the staff will be there. So he is going to be moving the target, moving the target. So when it is going to be while he is going to be operating the target, so the level man is going to be looking through the telescope. When it is going to be bisected, you are going to be stopping that one, and he can able to read the reading. In previous case, the target is not going to be available. Looking through the telescope, where it is going to be bisected, you are adjusting with the focusing one. Where it is going to be bisected, then we are going to be taking the reading in the self-reading. The self-reading, the target is going to be not available. Looking through is naked eye. So where the crosshairs is going to be bisecting that the staff, and he is going to be reading the taking the reading itself. So that is the staff reading. That is going to be completely depending upon the instrument and as well as the eyesight of the level eyesight of the level man. Based on that one, he can able to take the reading, note down the reading. But in the targeted staff, what is going to happen? Both level man and the staff man is going to be working simultaneously. He is going to be moving the target. So where it is going to be bisecting, so through the telescope, the crosshairs is going to be bisecting. He can able to stop that one. For that reading, he can able to read, and he is able to note down the reading. So it is going to be very easy when you are going to be compared to the self-reading one. In the self-reading one, it is very difficult to adjust the eyesight of the person, and as well as has to be read that the staff, so holding by the staff person or the staff man. So that is the difficulty will be there. That difficulty can able to take is going to be eliminated in the case of the targeted staff. The targeted staff, the target is going to be moving. So the level person is going to be looking through the telescope. When it is going to bisect the target with the crosshairs, then he can able to say that the staff man to hold it. So then he is going to be taking the reading. That the advantage will be the targeted staff. So this is the accessories that we are going to be using for the leveling survey. Is going to be called as, one is level instrument, second one is going to be called as staff. Levels will be dumpy level, Y level, tilting level, automatic level. Staff will be self-reading staff and targeted staff. So what are the advantages, the of the self-reading staff and targeted staff, and what is the maximum length of the staff is 4 meters, and what is the least count of the staff is, the least count is 5 mm. Both the cases least count is 5 mm. Like then the each division will be 5 mm. Like that, it is going to be having total 4 meters will be there. So with the help of leveling instrument and the staff, so we can able to take down the vertical measurement or the vertical distance, or it is going to be called as height, or we can say that the elevation of that point. Then with respect to the benchmark, we are going to be calculated the reduced level. Then after understanding that the what are the accessories or the instruments that we are going to be used for the carrying out the leveling work, then next one is going to be know about that the, what are the temporary adjustments of the level.
Temporary adjustments of level. Adjustments of level. Here the adjustments, we can say that one is temporary, another one is going to be called as permanent.
One is going to be the temporary, another one is going to be called as a permanent one. So here what we are going to be doing is, what is the purpose of temporary adjustment and what is the purpose of permanent adjustments? Adjustments is that if the instrument is going to be, so they are out of control or out of work, so then we are going to be doing, so the operations is going to be called temporary adjustments and permanent adjustments. Temporary adjustments means time being we are going to be adjusting, time being we are going to make that the adjustment or the repairs to the leveling instrument that can be able to carry out the progress of the work. That is going to be called as temporary.
So temporary
that we are going to be doing by the level man.
So this permanent adjustment is going to be called as instrumentation person.
Instrumentation person. Permanent adjustment is going to be called as, while after doing the temporary adjustments also, the level instrument is not going to be properly working. It's completely out of control. We are not able to use it. So then we have to go for repair. We are going to give the repair. That is going to be called as permanent adjustments. So permanent adjustments is that, so we are able to control that the complete instrument itself, complete instrument, some of the parts is not going to be working and we are not able to get the appropriate readings. So then we have to go for the permanent adjustment. Temporary adjustments is we can able to adjust that the eyepiece or the object glass temporarily. So then we can able to carry out the work. Permanent adjustments means that so it has to be carried out by the known person, the instrumentation person. Whoever is going to manufacture the dummy level or the leveling instrument, he can know about the what are the various components are there. So which component is not going to be working, he is going to be done properly and he has to repair it. So that is where going to be called as permanent adjustments. That is going to be done by the instrumentation engineer, not the level person or the level man. Temporary adjustment can do anyone, so that who knows about the dummy level or the leveling instrument temporarily. For the time being, so we can able to adjust is going to be called as temporary adjustments. Out of control, then permanently, then we have to go for the repairing, then it is going to be done by the instrumentation engineer. This is about what are the differences between temporary adjustments and permanent adjustments. So then the next is the temporary adjustments. What are the adjustments that is going to be coming under the temporary adjustments? Temporary adjustments of the level. First one is the select a suitable position. Select the suitable position. Second adjustment is going to be called fixing level with the tripod. Then approximate leveling.
by legs of tripod. Perfect loading by foot screws. Focusing the eyepiece. Focusing the eyepiece and object glass. So taking the reading. Taking the reading. So these are the six adjustments is going to be coming under the temporary adjustments of a level. So that is mainly we are in the dumpy level. So what are the temporary adjustments of a dumpy level? First is going to be called a select suitable position. Select suitable position. Second one is fixing the level with the tripod. Approximate leveling by legs of a tripod stand. Perfect leveling by the foot screws, focusing the eyepiece and as well as the focusing the object glass. Last one is going to be called all the five operations we are going to complete it. Then the instrument is going to be ready. Then we have to take that the reading. Take the reading from the staff by using that the telescope. So now one by one we are able to so discuss what is the first two, the level of adjustment is going to be called as select the suitable position. Suitable position means it is going to be called always we have to see that level or firm ground. Select the suitable position is going to be called as keep that the so the tripod stand and as well as leveling instrument. If it is going to be ground will be level or the firm or the so the surface is going to be properly leveled, then it is going to be called the select suitable position. So that position is not required that much time. We have to see that select position suitable position such that leveling instrument is going to be fixed firmly. For that purpose, we are going to be taking the select suitable position. It is not going to be tilting at any point of the time during the progress of the work. That we are going to be called a select suitable position. Then the second one is second operation is going to be called as fixing level with a tripod stand. Fixing level with a tripod. So this is tripod. So this we are going to call as level. So this we are going to call as tripod. So this is the level. So tripod means it is going to be called three legs is there. That's why we are going to tripod. This is the stand. Over the stand we are going to be fixing that the level. So the other two components will be the stand and as well as the leveling instrument. We'll be fixing there, so the clamp and nuts by the level is going to be fixing to the tripod stand. This is the fixing level with the tripod properly, or we can say that the rigidly fixed to the tripod stand. It is not going to be moving. So that the second temporary adjustment we are going to be doing. The third adjustment is going to be called as approximate leveling by legs. Legs of tripod stand. Approximate leveling by legs of the tripod stand. So here what we are going to be doing is so we are going to be moving, this is the three legs will be there. So we are going to be moving in such a way that legs is going to be separated in such a way that we have to fix the tripod. Approximate leveling means, so if the top surface is going to be properly, it is not going to be, one leg is going to be very, we are going to be stretching more. What is going to happen? It is going to be inclined. So your head is going to be inclined. But that's why what we are going to be doing, stretching of the legs approximately in a equal direction and equal position, then we are able to get that the level at the it's a tripod stand, the head of the tripod stand will be properly leveled. So that is known as the approximate leveling by legs of the tripod stand, such that we are going to be taking the less time to go for the leveling up of the operation. This is the third temporary adjustment we are going to be doing, that stretching of the legs of a tripod stand in the proper direction in the proper inclination.
The fourth operation is the perfect leveling by foot screws. Perfect leveling by foot screws.
Perfect leveling by foot screws.
So means here it is going to be having
a 3 foot screws will be there.
So in the leveling head,
the leveling head 3 foot screws will be there. So 3 foot screws, how we are going to adjust it? First, what we are going to be doing is your telescope
is going to be parallel to 1, 2, 3.
So telescope is going to be parallel to the first 2 foot screws. Telescope is going to be parallel to the first 2 foot screws, parallel to the 2 foot screws. And we are going to be rotating that the foot screws in such a way that bubble will be there in the leveling head. Like this, the bubble will be there in the leveling head. In the leveling head, the bubble is going to be comes to the center. If it is going to be, bubble will be like this will be there. The bubble position will be like this will be there. This is going to be wrong. So in such a way that you have to make sure that the bubble has to be comes to the center. The bubble is going to be comes to the center. If it is here, we are going to be rotating that the second screw. If it is here, we are only rotating the first screw. So simultaneously, we are going to be operating that the foot screw in such a way that the bubble is going to be center of its turn. Means that is the first thing we are going to be doing. So parallel to, so first step is going to be called as parallel to first 2 foot screws. So telescope parallel to 2 foot screws. Adjusted that the your bubble is going to be center. Then the telescope is going to be
parallel to other 2 foot screws. Here the first is 1 and 2. Here we are using 2 and 3.
Anything 2 and 3 are the 1 and 3. So next 2 foot screws, telescope is going to be rotating. Then we are going to be total head is going to be leveling head is going to be rotating, and the telescope is going to be parallel to the 2 and 3 or 1 and 3. So once again we are going to be operating clockwise or anti-clockwise direction in such a way that it is going to be coming to the so the center of its run, bubble is going to be center of its run. So then after that, total leveling head is going to be rotated, and then we have to be see that the first position 1 and 2, and the bubble will be center or not, we have to be check it. So then once again 2 and 3, bubble is going to be center or not, we check it. This is we are going to be called as perfect leveling by the foot screws in such a way that if it is going to be, so any number of rotations, so the leveling head, then the bubble is going to be center. The bubble is going to be center, then your instrument is going to be perfectly leveled. Centering is done and perfectly leveled. So then instrument is going to be ready to take out the readings. So that is line of collimation is going to be exactly perfect, or line of sight is going to be exactly perfect while you are going to be operated through the foot screws.
So first is going to be your telescope is going to be parallel to the first 2 foot screws,
and make sure that it is going to be rotating that the foot screws so simultaneously, and then it is going to be coming to that the center of its run. Then we are going to parallel to the next 2 foot screws. So once again we are going to be make sure that the foot screws is going to be rotated clockwise or anti-clockwise direction simultaneously. So make sure that the bubble is going to comes to the center of its run. Means other direction also. Means one is horizontal, another one is going to be the X direction, Y, X and Y directions. X and Y directions, the instrument is going to be properly leveled. You rotate it once again 360 degrees and we have to come to the first position 1 and 2. Telescope is going to be keeping parallel to the 1 and 2, and we have to check the bubble is center or not. If it is not, once again we have to be repeating the same process. If it is there, so then we have to check once again the bubble, telescope is going to be parallel to the 2 and 3 foot screws. We have to be check that bubble is center or not. If it is center, then instrument is properly leveled. with x and y directions. If not, once again repeating the same process. So rotating the foot screws clockwise or anti-clockwise direction in such a way that we are able to get that the bubble is going to be center of reference. This is known as the perfect leveling by the foot screws. So fifth one is going to be called a focusing eyepiece. Focusing the eyepiece. Focusing the eyepiece means the telescope will be having, this is one end, this is the other end. So this is going to be called as eyepiece. This is where going to be called as object end. Eyepiece is with respect to the level person, near to the level person, we are going to look into the object end is going to be far end of the telescope. The near end is eyepiece and our far end is going to be called object end, is going to be provided with the object glass. And here we are going to provide the focusing screw. So this is focusing screw we are going to provide it. Focusing screw. So what is the meant of focusing the eyepiece? Eyepiece will be having that, we are having the crosshairs like this. Eyepiece will be having that the crosshairs will be there. Crosshairs will be there. In some of the cases, the crosshairs will be like this. So eyepiece will be having the crosshairs. The crosshairs is going to be visible or not. That is we are going to be checking, is going to be called as focusing eyepiece, because this has to be intersect with that the staff, and we are going to be taking that the reading in the vertical direction or the vertical measurement. That's why it is going to be visible or not. We are going to be checking through that the adjustment is going to be called as focusing eyepiece. For that, what we are going to be doing is, we are going to be keeping that the white paper on the object end of the glass, that is the object glass, and we are looking through the eyepiece, we can able to see that visibility of the crosshairs. If not visible, then we are adjusting the eyepiece in and out, adjusting the eyepiece in and out, rotating the eyepiece in and out, such that the crosshairs is going to be visible through the looking through that the white paper visible. So then the adjustment is going to be completed. Sometimes it is not visible. We are going to be rotating the eyepiece in and out such that we have to make sure that the crosshairs is going to be visible. If it is visible, then it's going to be go for the next adjustment is going to be focusing the object glass. Focusing the object glass. Next adjustment is going to be called as focusing object glass. So this is the object end, this is eyepiece, and this is object end. So object end, so you have object end of the object glass is going to provide, object glass is going to be provided. So here focusing screw is available. Means that we are, the object is clearly visible. Previous case in the crosshairs and the eyepiece is going to be visible or not. We are going to be checking, keeping the white paper on the object end, and we are going to be rotating the eyepiece in and out, and we have to make sure that the crosshairs is going to be visible. Here, second case, focusing object glass such that you have to keep any object or you keep the staff, the readings is visible or not. The readings is going to be visible or not in the staff, that we are going to be checking, that we are going to be called object glass, focusing the object glass by using the object end. For that we are going to be using that, this the telescope will be there here, but they are going to be provided that the so the focusing screw, adjusting the focusing screw in and out, we can able to see that like the camera, how we are going to be adjusting that the focal length or the focusing. The same way we are going to be adjusting that the focusing of the object end with the object glass, and we can able to see that the object clearly, clear vision of the objects. We are going to be finding out that adjustment, we are going to be called as focusing the object glass. So these are the around the temporary adjustments, five temporary adjustments. First, we are going to select the suitable position, then fixing the leveling level instrument on the tripod stand, then approximate leveling by the tripod stand, then perfect leveling by the foot screws, then the focusing the eyepiece, focusing the object glass is going to be completed, means your instrument is going to be ready to take out the readings. You can go for the leveling work, instrument is going perfectly ready. So these are all we are going to be checking before we are going to be going for a field work. the instrument is going to be checked. So that are all we are going to be called as temporary adjustments. Permanent adjustment is that the instrument is going to be completely out of order. It is not going to be working. So then the instrumentation engineer, he is going to be making the repair and then make sure that in a working condition. That is going to be done by the instrumentation engineer. He is going to be called as permanent adjustments. Temporary adjustments, anybody can able to done. So these are the temporary adjustment arrangements we are going to provide. So with this, today's session we discussed about that what are the different types of the levels. So because we are going for leveling work, level instrument and leveling staff, these are the two accessories we are going to take it out for the level field work. In level, what are the different types of the levels? Dumpy level, Y level, tilting level, and automatic level. In staff, what are the different types of the staffs are available? Is self-reading staff and target staff. Then after understanding this one, level instrument and staff, then what are the temporary adjustments and what are the permanent adjustments? Temporary adjustments is in the field itself, we are going to be carried out. Make sure that the instrument is going to be working condition. Or we are going to be checking that the instrument before leaving to the field work is going to be called as temporary adjustments. Permanent adjustment has to be done by the instrumentation engineer. So with this, we are going to be concluding this session. Next session, we are going to be discussing about the methods of leveling.